I'm going to show you how to create crosstab queries using the query wizard in Access. So let's close all the queries that we have open, and we're going to use this query revenue by customer and service that we just created to create a crosstab query. So under create, we use the query wizard to select the crosstab query. And then we're going to select from our queries the query revenue by customer and service. We're going to add in the customer first name. The service name is going to be, for example, in this case, you can see the image below. The first name is going to be the row of our crosstab. And then across the top is going to be our columns. And in between, what do we want? We want the sum of all of the services. So we're going to sum the service fee and aggregate that. So click OK. We're going to view this the query, and we're just going to leave the default name that Access is providing here. So now we can see for each person which service they spent money on, right? So we can say Cindy spent $30 on boarding in total. Now let's go into Design View and switch things up a bit. We can do a few things here. We have a row heading, and we've got a column heading. Let's swap those and see what the result looks like. Okay, it's a little bit more condensed here vertically, but now we have a lot of horizontal scroll in order to see the data. I think this query would actually be also effective if we looked at it from the category. So let's save this, and let's copy the crosstab query here and paste it. And this time we'll look at it by category. So just rename it as such, close the original, and open the new one in Design View. Now we need to pull in the category name, and to do that we'll add the service table. And because this is now orphaned, we don't see any relationships between them, we can create sort of a basic, very quick relationship between these two tables just by creating the association between the same fields. So this is the query, these are the fields that are coming in from the query, and this is the other table. So now we don't have an orphan table, and we can pull in the category as it relates to the sum of the service fee and the customer. So we'll just drag and drop the service category here, which will pop over to the right, the remaining columns, and then using the downward arrow here, I'll select the column that I want to delete, and then hit delete on my keyboard. So now we're going to set this as the row heading, and let's take a look at our results. So we've got now the categories rather than the services, the sum of all the total, and then our customers along the top here in the cross tabulation of how much money they spent on each of these category services. Let's swap that one more time, changing the row heading and the column heading, and running again. And save.